Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel NetCast. I'm Bill Jelen. A couple days ago, I was solving the Jeopardy Masters, what are the odds of a tie, and I had to do all combinations. The digits 1 to 6, 6 different scenarios for 4 different games, and I did this horrible formula for counting up in binary, but it wasn't binary, it was sort of base 6, but not really base 6, because it went from 1 to 6 instead of 0 to 5. I use this method a lot. I'm not proud of this method. Just type the numbers 1 to 6 here, and then grab the number from 6 rows above. Copy that down. And then the formula here, checking to see if the number to the right of us is a 1, the number above us is a 6. If it is, then add 1 to the number above us. Unless it's already a 6, then reset back to 1. And thankfully, Kyle Freistedt sent me again the easy steps to do this. He did this the last time when I was doing the World Cup. And honestly, yesterday, I knew there was an easier way to do it. I just couldn't remember what it was. So I'm going to document it and try and learn it. So the first thing we do is we're going to do 1,296 numbers, but not starting from 1. We're going to start from 0, like that. So we get the number 0 to 1,295. That's our 1,296 numbers. And then Kyle uses equal base. We're going to convert that to base 6. So 06 hash, we'll get all 1,296 numbers in base 6 with a minimum length of 4. All right, and that generates almost what I need. Right, but what I need is instead of 000, I need 1111. So very cleverly, Kyle just adds. It's amazing that this kind of works. 1111 like that, and we get exactly what I need. Now it's all in one column, so I'm going to do some tricks to break it out into 4 columns. But this is much easier than what I had done here with 2 different formulas and just a bunch of typing. Right. It's one of those things I just have to learn. And then, of course, Kyle put it all in one formula like that, right? We don't need the extra columns. It's just that formula. For me, it's easier to explain it in the multiple columns. All right, so here's the big test. Let's do some other scenario, right? Let's say that we have, 3 columns, and the number of scenarios is 7. All right, so the first thing to do is figure out how many rows we're going to need. So that's the number 7. Raised to the third power. Because for the first column, it could be the numbers 1 to 7, so there's 7 possibilities. And then for the second column, again, the numbers, so 7 times 7 times 7 is 7 raised to the third power. But I'm just trying to make this nice and general. All right, so we know that we have 343. And so we're going to do a sequence of that number starting from 0. We get the numbers 0 to 342. All right. And then we're going to wrap that whole thing in the base function. And for the radix, it is this number, this input cell here, 7. And the minimum number of digits is the number of columns that we want at the end, so 3. Cool, great. And then from there, this great trick from Kyle, just add, in this case, 111 because it's only 3 digits. Beautiful. Now I'm starting to think about how I'm going to break that back out. It's funny, TEXTSPLIT can break at a dash, but it can't say, break it into every one character. I'm thinking ahead here on the fly. Could we do equal mid of this? Where are we going to start? We're going to start at the sequence of 3. One row, 3 columns for a length of 1. Yeah, that would work. And then double click to copy that down. Except double click doesn't work for these array formulas. Okay, let me go back to the original plan here. Sorry, this is longer. I'm going to wrap the whole thing in the text function, and I'm going to add those hyphens in. So 0, hyphen, 0, hyphen, 0, like that. And then here, I should be able to do equal text split of this text, split it at the dash. Good. And then can I do AB9 hash, or is that going to run into the array of array problems? Of course it's the array of array problems. All right. So we have our formula there. At this point, I guess I'm going to go back to the old formula. Come down to the bottom. So that was control down arrow. Move over to the right with the right arrow. Control shift up, and then control D is the fast way to copy that down. And then, of course, copy and paste those values and go on with the rest of yesterday's video. Thanks to Kyle for sending this in. He sent it in last time when I did the World Cup, and I just didn't, it's one of those things I saw it, I was like, oh, that's cool. But then the next time I needed it, I could not remember it. So we'll have to, I'm going to have to bookmark, me personally, I'll have to bookmark this video so the next time it comes up, I can come back and use this great little formula here instead of the just convoluted way that I did it yesterday. All right, so hey, thanks to Kyle for sending that formula in a second time. Thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another NetCast from Mr. Excel. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.